from rural Louisiana and Texas. He was a sniper. We're going to talk about a lot of the black Americans who have been forgotten. He was my uncle, and he was a part of Paris. She said, "What do you call yourself? Black American, Afro-American, Negro, black?"
It's not about black or white, yellow or red, no. Everything is not based on race, not at all. But there's a thing called a code, and we're going to talk about the code.
This is the hotel on Rue Christine, Hotel Christine. This is where James Baldwin stayed, the famous writer. And as I put this chess set together, it represents a lot of people who came here, past, present, and future. Uncle Mose, he was a sniper, like I mentioned. He also was one of those that liberated Nazi death camps. There we go. All right, this is the chess set. As I sit here in this district, we had James Baldwin that was in this district. Chester Himes was in this district. Chester Himes wrote the book called Cotton Comes to Harlem. Then you had Richard Wright that was here, who wrote Native Son. I do Black American tours, but my tour is unique in that it's being told by a Black American. An American first, a Black American, generational Black American, not an African American. When I first got to Paris, this French lady wanted to interview me. She said, "What do you call yourself? Black American, Afro-American, Negro, black?" I said, wait a minute, darling. My family's been in the country for 300 years. In this district, my dear friend Ed Moses was responsible for getting the Olympics back to Paris. He has a vote on that committee. And as we have the conflict with what's going on in Ukraine, he met with Putin twice about the Olympic Games there. I'm just moving now, but you know, just for the camera. There was a Finnish collectors, they came here, they were looking for me, and they wanted a painting. So they came up to my little studio, and they saw a little small painting that was Uncle Mose in Paris. And I didn't want to sell it, but they wanted to buy it. And I needed money at the time, so I sold it. So these Finnish collectors, they were executives of a salmon factory in the northern part of Finland. So today, you could see Uncle Mose's picture on top of the, the factory there, and in the executive suite. So Uncle Mose made it all the way to Finland. He never been there, but you know, he was there. So anyway, this is a prelude, an opening to Black American tours. We're gonna talk about James Baldwin, we're gonna talk about Richard Wright, we're gonna talk about Chester Himes, we're gonna talk about Louis Armstrong, we're gonna talk about Duke Ellington, we're gonna talk about Miles Davis. They all lived in my district. So this is an introductory, so we're gonna walk around in this fine hotel. A lot of movie stars come here. I met a lot of movie stars in this, I didn't meet Marlon Brando. They stayed here. Anyway, they come here to get away from the paparazzi. Anyway, so that's the first segment of this, and you find it interesting. I'm not going to show you everything, you know, but this is to bait you in. Pawn to King 4, let's say pawn to King Bishop 3. Okay, this is about 10 years ago. I did a Black American tour with some very, very famous people. There were about 43 of them. It was headed up by Reggie Van Lee. Reggie is a multi-billionaire. There was Susan Taylor, who at the time was head of Essence magazine. So what happened, it rained over on Rue Mazeline. We came in here, we had a coffee, we had it over here. The point I'm trying to make is that these were power brokers. There was a gallery down the street on Rue Rudolph in. And I told him, I said, listen, I got some very important people here. Take all these shit paintings that you have in the gallery and put my paintings up. I said, the deal is this. The deal is that I get 80%, you get 20%. My exposition was for 1 hour. I made a lot of money in 1 hour, quite a bit. These are little stories about black Americans in Paris. They were totally insulted about certain things, but it is not the 50s, it's not the 60s, it's not the 40s, it's not the 30s, it's not the 20s. This was in the early 2000s. So when one person can tell his narrative, it's very important, whether you are Italian, American, if you want to say it, or you want to be this or that. When the first black Americans came to Paris or France via Louisiana back in the 18th century, the French slave plantation owners, they had mulatto children, so they sent their mulatto children to Paris for higher education, which I won't show you on this tour, but Alvin Aldrich at the Théâtre of Odéon. You know the Théâtre of Odéon? Well, they were there. They were very high class kids whose daddies were white and their mothers were black. So they were mulatto or mestizo. Now, the French had a thing called the Code Noir. The Code Noir attributed to the people in the Caribbean. It didn't apply to me because we were different. When you had a bunch of generational black Americans come in here, they were like, whoa, they were blown away. These people were very important people. That's why when you see the Africans that are here, they're under the plantation colonial system. It's a difference. It's a difference between, Russians, Belarus, Ukrainians. There's a difference between Koreans, Japanese, Chinese. Most people can't see that. So what happened in this hotel was called the Taboo. The Taboo during the time of the occupation of the Nazis. There were famous people that played here from Duke Ellington to Louis Armstrong. But during the Nazi period, jazz was at the basement here. And there's a movie with Sidney Poitier, who just died. It was called Paris Blues, 1960, where the Taboo, the image of the smoky jazz, smoking cigarettes, jazz playing, it was here. The Nazis were here. It was verboten to listen to black American jazz. But then we have to bring into account, his name was Boris Vann. Boris Vann was very instrumental in bringing black jazz to Paris. But it was a black form. And the time of the Taboo, the American soldiers that first came here, they were black Americans that came here, since I'm talking about my people. Everybody knew the French were not good fighters, hell no. So the thing about it was that the Americans drafted, they sent a lot of black soldiers to fight in the French army, which they kicked a lot of ass, a lot of Nazi ass. But then they were playing this music they didn't know. And it was called jazz. They were called the Harlem Hellfighters. And what happened was that Bojangles with Shirley Temple, you might see some remnants of Bojangles dancing. But these people, the French were like, they could play these instruments another different way, and what they did. So what happened, we talk about Josephine Baker came here in 1927. All right, she kind of controlled the 20s. The 30s, somewhat the 40s. The 40s came about, here comes the beboppers. We talk about Miles Davis, Dexter Gordon. A lot of black Americans brought jazz right here. This was called the Taboo. The Taboo is one of the meccas of the jazz movement right here in this hotel. Now it's about, I think it's about 1,000 euros a night. Okay.
You'll find other places very interesting.
Alcazar.
And this is a very famous place. This is where Duke Ellington had his 50th birthday party. A lot of people came here from, you name them, they were black Americans. So anyway, it's got great decor from the Art Deco period, and Fabrice, he's the manager, and he's gonna say a few words.
Thank you, darling.
Okay.
You know, it's not, it's a, just a little house, it's a maison, you know? No. Everybody is very welcoming here. It's a part of the world, it's a big part of my heart. And welcome to the Alcazar. Please.
This right here is called the Louisiana Hotel. This is where all the beboppers came right after the jazz movement in the 40s. We're talking about Miles Davis. We're talking about Dexter Gordon. So this place right here was a lot of freedom. Bud Powell, Buttercup was his wife. They used to cook fried chicken right there. We're talking about the 50s. Black America was very new to French people. Black Africans, they were mostly under my thumb. They were colonialists. They were under the colonial influence of France. And this is true. Nobody's gonna tell you that, but it's true. Sir, yes, sir. Yeah, no. Black America came over here not knowing colonial black people. We grew up next door to the plantation in the United States. When the black folks came here, Dexter Gordon, Miles Davis, Coltrane, these right here, this was the heart of like the Taboo. The Taboo was heart of jazz back in the 40s. This was also the heart of the jazz movement. This was the bebop movement.
Okay, this is the Josephine Baker Plaza, and they erected this in 2002. I was here in 2002, and this is Mom Panas, and she is only the second African American, excuse me, Black American, that has a plaque dedicated to her. We'll see the other one later on. James Baldwin, Richard Wright, and Chester Hines, they came here, right here. And it could have been a great screenplay. Once upon a time, I had always thought that Will Smith could be Richard Wright. And I thought that, what's his name? Van Peebles would have been Chester Hines, and Wesley Snipes would have been James Baldwin. But that would be a great, great, great screenplay when all three of them met here back in the early 60s, but they didn't like each other. What a shame. They just didn't like each other, but they met once upon a time, right here.
Richard Wright wrote the book Native Son, which was translated in every language on the planet. A Black American in Paris. It's called The Man of Letters, The Black American, Richard Wright. That's what it is translated.